Hi everybody, welcome back to Daytime York Region. Today we are shining the spotlight on three amazing York Region artists, young artists I should say. They are all contestants in the Royal Canadian Mint Coin Design Contest, which is on now, and coincidentally today is the last day of voting. So after the interview we really want you to go to the website to vote for these young artists who are living here in York Region. Thank you so much, ladies, for coming on today. We have Joelle to my left, and then we have Candace, and we have Kelly. And they've all done different designs, and they've brought their designs here today to talk about really what inspired them to do the contest, what inspired their design, and really to spread the word about this great contest. Candace, we'll start with you. When your art teacher, you all go to the same art school, it's called Beware Wet Paint, in Markham, when she suggested that you do a coin design and enter this contest, what were your first thoughts?
Well, my first thoughts were I wanted my concept to be related to the contest theme, the future of Canada. So I have with me some of my rough sketches. So I thought about using planets and gears and spare parts because I wanted to talk about science advancing in Canada.
Can I see some of those sketches?
Sure.
And where's the design of your final coin?
Here.
Wow, okay, so basically you start off with kind of a rough sketch, and did you pick kind of your favorite parts and
yeah.
see what would really work on a coin design?
Yeah, I mixed and matched a few different things together.
Now this is your final coin design though, is that right?
Yes.
So what do we see here? What did you decide on for the final concept?
Well, the small leaf in the right corner is talking about Canada in the present, and the bigger leaf is talking about Canada in the future because it's half natural, half mechanic.
That's beautiful.
Meaning that like there will be a balance of nature and mechanics in the future.
I love that. What a great concept.
Thank you.
And Kelly, let's take a look at your coin. When you were given this task, what were your first thoughts? Because you also went with kind of a nature theme. Oh, that's Joelle's. Joelle, I'm sorry. Joelle, this is beautiful. Tell us about what you decided to do here.
I use the hands so then they can grow a plant to protect the animals for the environment in the future.
That's such a nice idea. I'm very impressed with your artwork, ladies.
These are my sketches.
Oh, so you like to draw animals. Is the environment something that's important to you?
Yes.
Yes. And you're only 8 years old.
I love animals.
She loves animals. Which is perfect, and that's why you decided to do that design, right?
Yes.
You also brought a painting, which we have to show. Is this one of the paintings you've done at your art class?
Yes.
I'm just going to hold it up here. Look at this. 8-year-old Joelle, I'm very impressed. And what did you do on this painting?
I drew a turtle, a beaver, and a goose.
Wow. Is this supposed to be like a stamp?
Yes.
Very nice. A 50-cent stamp. Thank you for bringing that. And Kelly, we'll talk about your coin now. So let's see a picture. What design elements did you go with to come up with your concept?
I used 3 different symbolic icons, the beaver, the Inukshuk, and the maple leaf, to represent the diversity of art and culture in Canada.
That's nice. Did it take you a long time to decide what you wanted to draw?
Well, I had a painting
yeah.
that inspired me to draw.
Let's take a look. Oh, this is beautiful. So did you guys start off with paintings?
Yeah.
That then kind of became the coin?
Yeah.
Yeah. Are you proud of this when you look at this artwork?
Sort of, yeah.
It's amazing. You're all very talented. What's your favorite thing about doing art? Does anybody want to answer that? What do you like best about being an artist and taking art classes and doing this?
So then we can paint. Like, the color of the pictures look beautiful.
They are beautiful. What about you, Candace? What's
it
your favorite thing?
It gives us a chance to like express ourselves as individuals and express our feelings and emotions through art.
Love that. And what about you, Kelly?
Learning different things. Yeah.
Good. Well, I'm very impressed, ladies. And we have to say that We want people to vote on the website. You are all finalists, so you had to submit your drawings, and then you were all chosen as finalists. There are finalists, I believe, all over the country, right? And you are some of the people who are from York Region. There were only a couple from York Region who were chosen, and basically, people can go to the website. So when you go to the website, everybody, it's mint.ca/Canada150. The contest has been on for some time, but is ending today. So voting ends today. So go to the website, put your vote in, and hopefully one of these ladies can win. I think that would be nice, right? What happens if you win the contest?
Our coin gets made into a real coin. We get $2,000 cash, a trip to Ottawa, and we're invited to the grand unveiling of the new designs.
No kidding.
Yeah.
So you each want to win this. This would be pretty amazing. Can people vote more than once, or how does it work? Do we know how the voting works?
Voting's unlimited.
Yeah, you can spam votes.
You get spare votes.
You get spam. You can spam votes.
Oh.
Do it as many times as you want and like whatever design you want.
Oh, cool. Okay. So that's pretty neat. You can go to the website. You can vote more than once. Have you guys been telling everybody you know?
Yes.
Vote for me. Vote for me. Good stuff. I wish you all the best. I will be going and I will be voting for each of you after the show.
Thank you
so much, ladies. Go to the website, mint.ca/Canada150. After the break, we're heading over to the daytime kitchen. Stay tuned.